Hello everyone, the topic of presentation is ethmoid air cells, and I'm sure you would have heard these words: bulla ethmoidalis, Egger nezae, Onodi cell, Heller cell, Conca bullosa. They are really very easy things to understand, and in this presentation we'll try to understand them and see them radiologically as well. First of all, about presenter, I am Rajiv Dhawan, and I'm trained at Lady Harding Medical College, New Delhi, and All India Institute of Medical Sciences, New Delhi. Scope of presentation is, we'll understand anatomy and radiology of ethmoid air cells for undergraduate medical students. Okay. This is of importance for your upcoming NEET paper and the next examination as well. Now, first of all, ethmoid bone is a single bone in the body. It is between two orbits. I repeat, it's a single bone. Can you see the yellow color bone? It's between two orbits. Now, so this is your skull. Now, in your skull, if you see, this red thing is the ethmoid bone, a single bone which is having two halves, two labyrinthi. And these labyrinthi have got multiple air cells called ethmoid air cells. Orbit between the two is the ethmoid bone, and above that is the brain, okay, in the skull. Now, ethmoid air cells are divided into two groups. Ethmoid is a long bone between the two orbits. So imagine a partition between the bone, which will divide it into two components. That division, that septum, which separates the ethmoid air cells into two groups called anterior group and posterior group, that bony septum is called ground lamella or basal lamella. Look at the red color thing. Imagine this, the black thing is the whole bone. The red thing is the partition between the bone, and this partition is called ground lamella or basal lamella. Cells in front of this ground lamella are called anterior ethmoid air cells. Cells posterior to this lamella are called posterior ethmoid air cells. Now let's understand them further. The number wise, the anterior ethmoid air cells vary from 2 to 8, and posterior are from 1 to 8. Okay, let's talk about anterior ethmoid air cells. Now I'm saying anterior ethmoid air cells are 2 to 8. Look at the purple circle. These two are constant. For sure, these two cells will be there definitely. Rest of the things are variable. Maybe there are 6 more cells, 5 more cells, but these two will be there. Okay, so these two will be there, will give number to them, name to them. They are constant cells. What are the name of these cells? Number one cell is bulla ethmoidalis, and number two cell will be Egger nezae. Once again, I want to say anterior ethmoid air cells are 2 to 8 in number. The two are constant cells. Everyone will have these two cells. So the name of these two cells is bulla ethmoidalis, and second one is Egger nezae. Now let's define them. Number one, bulla ethmoidalis. It is the most constant and largest anterior ethmoid air cell. The main thing is largest. We know it is constant. It's the largest anterior ethmoid air cell. Now, let me try to show you a CT scan. Don't get, you know, scared of looking at CT. It's a very simple thing. Now, this is your orbit. Let me take it on the other sheet. I will explain it to you in easy way. So let's understand radiology of bulla ethmoidalis and Egger nezae. Now please see, this is orbit. This is orbit. Between the two orbit, the bone is called ethmoid bone. Okay. Above that is the brain, of course. This is the brain image. Okay. Now in the ethmoid bone, in the anterior part, you see a large cell. Look at the EB word written there. This cell, this large cell, this one is bulla ethmoidalis. Bulla ethmoidalis. Okay. Now, this is, of course, the maxillary sinus. Maxillary sinus, of course. Okay. And I'm sure you can see this is inferior turbinate of this side. This is inferior turbinate of this side. Okay. So, once again, see this image, and you will be able to see that EB is bulla ethmoidalis And MT is the middle turbinate. This is inferior turbinate. This is maxillary sinus. Of course, these two are the orbits. Now, number two, Egger-Nezhai. The specialty of Egger-Nezhai is it is the anterior most anterior ethmoid air cell. Again, it's a constant cell, agreed. But the specialty is its most anterior cell. It is in front of the bulla ethmoidalis even. Okay, so if you take a section of the ethmoid bone, the most anterior cell in that would be the Egger-Nezhai. Now, please see this image. And let me take that image with you on this sheet. And please see, where are we? First of all, this is anterior, of course, the nose. And this is posterior. Now, please see, this one is the frontal sinus. Okay. Imagine it's a sagittal section. Okay. Frontal sinus. This is the inferior turbinate. Okay. Now, this hole is the ethmoid bone. This hole is ethmoid bone. Okay. Now, this segment, please see, this is ground lamella. I hope you remember. Ground lamella, also called the basal lamella, divide this bone into two group of cells, anterior ethmoid air cells and posterior ethmoid air cells. Okay. Now let's see once again this image. Now we know where to focus on this image. This is the ethmoid bone once again. Okay. This is ethmoid bone. Let me tell you here only, this is sphenoid. Please do remember, where the ethmoid ends, sphenoid start. This is sphenoid sinus. Okay. So this is S. So please focus in this rectangle. Okay. Now, I think you can now clearly see the most anterior cell here. This one. I am going to fill a yellow color in that. This is Egger-Nezhai. This is Egger-Nezhai. Once again, see this image without any label. Now, please see. If it is a sagittal section, the cell I'm going to fill with yellow color is the Egger-Nezhai. This anterior, please see, this is anterior. So this is the anterior most cell. So this cell is Egger-Nezhai. Okay. Okay. This is the ground lamella or basal lamella. These are the anterior ethmoid air cell. These are the posterior ethmoid air cells. And we remember where the ethmoid end, what start? Sphenoid start. So this is sphenoid sinus. Okay. Now come back to this image. So now we are clear. This is the Egger-Nezhai. Okay. Now see the radiology. Please see the axial section. Don't get confused. Don't get scared of these radiological images. They are easy to understand. Once again, see, this is orbit. Let me take the same thing on the sheet over here. Please see. Now this is your orbit. This is your orbit. Between the two orbit, this bone is called egg, the ethmoid bone. Okay. And you can see many ethmoid air cells. Okay. This is anterior. This is posterior. Mind you, it's axial section. From here to here, it's anterior ethmoid air cell. From here to here, it's the posterior ethmoid air cells. Now, where the ethmoid end, what starts? Sphenoid starts. This is SPS, is sphenoid sinus. Okay. We can see this one, the clearly the most anterior cell is anti-Egger-Nezhai cell. Okay. Egger-Nezhai cell. Once again, you can see yourself now. This is the Egger-Nezhai. We are seeing the axial section. It's a plain CT, anterior, posterior. Of course, this one is the Egger-Nezhai. Okay. Open clear. So let's revise once again. Bulla ethmoidalis is the most constant and largest cell. Can you see the largest cell of the anterior ethmoid group? Egger-Nezhai is the anterior most anterior ethmoid air cell. Now, let's go further. There are some anatomical variation. In some people, ethmoid air cells can grow in three unusual locations. Depending on those three unusual locations, we have given specific names to those cells. Okay. I repeat, two are definite cells. bullate modalis, agonizei are constant. They are definitely there in everyone. Now the upcoming three cells are variable cells. It's an anatomical variation. In three unusual locations, we can find special cells, and depending on the location, they have given name, been given name. Do remember, the ethmoid bone is between two orbits. If by chance the ethmoid cell extend into the floor of the orbit, they will be called Heller cell. If they grow very close to optic nerve, it is called Onod cell. If they grow inside middle turbinate, MT mane middle turbinate, it's called concha bullosa. These three are variable cells. First two were constant cells, these three are variable cells. I repeat, if ethmoid air cells grow into orbital floor, they are called Heller cell. Mind you, Heller cell is a part of anterior ethmoid air cell system. If these cells grow close to optic nerve, they are called Onod cell. Onod cell are part of posterior ethmoid air cell system. You know, optic nerve is behind. Optic nerve is very close to roof of sphenoid sinus. So it means Onod cell will be very close to sphenoid sinus. We'll see radiologically later on. And if they grow into the middle turbinate, it's called concha bullosa. Now, let me show you Heller cell. This is orbit. This is orbit. Okay, this cell is the Heller cell. Heller cell. You can very clearly see that it's very easy to interpret these CT scans. Don't get scared. Just feel confident that I know ethmoid bone is between two orbits. This is orbit. This is orbit. This is brain. Okay, orient yourself. Now, this is the ethmoid bone. We can see one cell extending in the floor of the orbit. This cell is Heller cell. Heller cell. Please understand, this is the Heller cell. Okay, now let's get back. Oh, this is the Onod cell. Now this you have to understand Onod. Now these two stars, let me take the image over there again. We are seeing the coronal sections. We have gone behind, posterior. You know, sphenoid sinus is right towards the end of the nose actually. I hope you remember where the ethmoid sinus ends, sphenoid sinus starts, to make it simple. Now please see, these two stars are the sphenoid sinus. This is the Onod cell, the single star, Onod. This is also Onod. Now, how can you really be sure it's Onod? Please understand, look at over here. Just to make it simple, this is the ethmoid bone. It ends, then starts the sphenoid sinus. Ethmoid sinus finishes, sphenoid sinus start. Now, if by chance the posterior cells get over pneumatized and extends towards the roof of sphenoid, then it is called Onod cell. Mind you, everyone doesn't have Onod cell. In some people, the pneumatization of the ethmoid bone, the ethmoid air cell system, can extend posteriorly towards the roof of sphenoid sinus. Ideally, in most of the people, where the ethmoid air cells end, sphenoid sinus start. But in this image, come back over here. In this image, please see, in the same coronal cut, you are seeing the sphenoid sinus. In the roof of the sphenoid sinus, you're seeing another cell of the posterior ethmoid air cell system, and that cell is called Onod cell. Onod cell. Okay, now get back. So this two star is sphenoid, the single star is the Onod. How to make it simple? Again, if you see an extra cell in the roof of the sphenoid sinus, think about Onod. I hope you remember anatomy. The roof of sphenoid sinus would have relation with the optic nerve also. Here you see another, this is S means sphenoid sinus. Above that, if you see another cell, think of Onod. And please see this white arrow is the optic nerve. Okay, optic nerve. Please understand what is the importance of Onod cell. If you have Onod cell in the patient you are operating for endoscopic sinus surgery, you are going very close to optic nerve. Okay, so there is a possibility of injury to optic nerve when the functional endoscopic surgery is being done. So before doing the sinus surgery, we must read our CT scans properly to pre-hand know all this variation of the ethmoid air cells. That's the surgical significance of these cells. Okay, so this is sphenoid sinus. In the roof of sphenoid sinus, we should not see any cell. But if we see any cell, it is called Onody. And Onody has got very close relation with what? Optic nerve. Optic nerve. Okay, and the last cell, the third one, look at this one, is inside middle turbinate. If by chance the ethmoid air cell extend into middle turbinate, it's called concha bullosa. Concha bullosa. Now, what is concha? Concha is the bony part of turbinate. Okay, I hope you remember, turbinate is the projection on the lateral wall of nose. There are three turbinates: inferior turbinate, middle turbinate, superior turbinate. Every turbinate has a bone inside called like inferior concha, middle concha, superior concha. So bony part of turbinate is called concha. Okay, so there are three turbinates. Now please see, inferior concha is an independent bone, but middle concha and superior concha, they are part of ethmoid bone. Please understand it clearly. Concha is the bony part of turbinate, and there are three concha because there are three turbinates. Inferior concha is an independent bone. Middle concha and superior concha are part of ethmoid bone. Okay. Now look at the skull. Now see over here again. This is the concept of the, just give me a minute, sorry. Now, this is your ethmoid bone. Okay, this is a perpendicular bit of ethmoid. This is your ethmoid bone. It has got two labyrinthi, and into that there are cells called ethmoid air cells. Okay, if they extend into here, this is a Heller cell. Okay, now please see, this is the inferior concha. Inferior concha. Am I clear? Please see, on the lateral wall of nose, you can see another bone over here. This is the lateral wall of nose. Now this is inferior concha. Inferior concha, when it is covered by mucosa and the submucosa, it is called the inferior turbinate. So turbinate is made of concha covered by mucosa and submucosa. Okay, so please see, this is the inferior concha, this one, inferior concha. Okay, when I cover the inferior concha with mucosa, it is called inferior turbinate. Okay, now please understand, inferior turbinate or inferior concha is independent bone, but middle concha, superior concha, they are part of ethmoid bone. Now please see, this is middle turbinate. This is middle turbinate. Okay, middle turbinate. So you have to imagine that inferior concha is independent bone, but this one, the middle concha, this is middle concha, is nothing but a hanging projection from the ethmoid bone only. If these cell extend into this concha also, over here, please understand, into this, there is cell formation here. Okay, then it is called concha bullosa. I repeat, please see from a closer view, this yellow thing is showing the middle concha, which is the part of what, ethmoid bone. If by chance these cell extend into the middle concha like this, and then it's an anatomical variation called concha bullosa. Concha means bony part of turbinate, bulla means cell. Concha bullosa. Now again, please see, this is your lateral wall of nose, inferior concha, we are clear about it. Now let's see the radiology of the concha bullosa. It's again easy. Now see on the screen the CT scan, again a coronal cut, and this is your orbit. This is your inferior turbinate, okay, or inferior concha inside. This is your maxillary sinus. Now this is your ethmoid bone. Let me repeat that the middle turbinate is nothing, or middle concha is nothing but a hanging projection from the ethmoid bone only. Okay. Now this is your middle concha. Now again, see this without labeling. Please see in this area. Now you should be able to see this is a hanging projection from the ethmoid bone only. Can you see a cell inside that? This cell is middle concha. This cell is concha bullosa, sorry. This bone is actually middle concha, and the cell inside the middle concha, which is anatomical variation, is called concha bullosa. Now let me label it for you once again. This is your concha bullosa. Concha bullosa. We can see again, this is your ethmoid bone, and this is a hanging projection, is called the middle concha, and the cell in the middle concha is called the concha bullosa. This one. Okay, again, this one is the concha bullosa. Please come back to the CT scan. I think we are sure about it. This is the concha bullosa now. Okay, I repeat, orbit. This is the ethmoid bone, maxillary sinus, inferior turbinate, inferior concha is independent bone, but middle concha is a hanging projection from the ethmoid bone. A cell in the middle concha is called concha bullosa. What is the surgical significance of concha bullosa? Concha bullosa may cause mechanical blockage to the drainage of sinuses. You can see the maxillary sinus is draining into the middle meatus, the bulky middle turbinate, because of the concha bullosa inside, that can lead to blockage of drainage of sinuses, and hence concha bullosa can be a contributing factor to the development of sinusitis in the patient actually. Okay, so this is about the ethmoid air cell I want to talk to you about. So these are three atypical cells. One is Heller cell in the orbital floor, close to optic nerve is Onod cell. If the cell grows inside the middle turbinate, it is called concha bullosa. Okay, now I hope you're clear about these five cells in the red color: Bullack medalis, agonizae, they are sure shot cell. Everybody has got these cells, but the rest three cells, Heller cell, Onod cell, concha bullosa, are the anatomical variations which are seen on CT scan. We must read our CT scan properly so that we do not have complications during the functional endoscopic sinus surgery. I hope you are able to understand these cells now in a proper way. Thank you very much.